morning. Welcome to build day 25. And Kaylee walks off. She wants to go move her truck. But we're just getting started. It's about 10 o'clock. I'm not rushing it. But so Ann's out here putting the last of the pumpkins in. She just got done helping me bring up all of this. This is all our AC stuff with the exception of those. Those are low voltage, but I want to get into their places. So I have an idea of how I want to run wiring and stuff. So we'll get those put in. But there's everything from the LED candles to flame pots to candelabras to light bulbs. First order of business, though, is that. There's 14 video cameras in there that will be spread throughout the haunt. Just about every display will get at least one. So we got to start getting them put in. That's going to be our first order of business, and then we're going to attack the tubs and start getting all that stuff put in. I have no idea if you're going to get very much footage. It just might be this clip, pie of the day, and end of the day wrap up. I don't know. Or you could have something else in between all that. Who knows? But I'm not going to get anywhere if I don't put the camera down and get to work. Let's see, breakfast of the day, handful of mints, some Ritz crackers, a couple of handfuls of popcorn, and a couple of slugs off of Coke. That's exactly what I've had this morning. I probably won't eat anything until late this afternoon after Kaylee's walk. So, time to get going. Gotta go park the truck. And keep Kaylee happy because she likes to park the truck. Yeah, she likes to go-go. She wants to go park that truck. Next clip coming up, hopefully. All right, first chore done. All 14 cameras are displayed, or not displayed, but installed. None of them are exactly aimed or hooked up to power as of yet. We haven't gotten to hooking things up to power quite yet. We're still trying to get things put out. Now the next one's going to be quick and simple. I got a bunch of LED candles that I made. And I'm going to go get those placed around before I tackle something like that, and it's got a little bit of everything. There's flame pots for the mausoleum in there, lights for the clown, and peepers that will be going in various bushes, so I'll be all over the haunt doing that one. But now, it's candle time. Well, progress made. We're down to the last tub of AC stuff that needs to go out, and this one takes a while. I got a Make-A-Wish sign that goes out front. I'm going to need to get a new one sooner or later. But other than that, it's pretty much all light bulbs. In fact, that one's out of its box. It goes in here. Those are the lights that go on the entrance and exit arc. And then these are the light bulbs that go on the marquees for the mausoleum, and then I got miscellaneous bulbs for everything else. Gotta get them put in. But nice thing is once these are all installed, then we can go back through and drag out all the wiring and start plugging things in. With all the power in the power box and stuff up and working, when I plug them in, things should work. So long as I have the switch thrown up there for it. But we're going to get started on that here in a bit. I'm taking a breather. Well, you just might get some nighttime footage after all. I've got all the electrical stuff in the haunt is installed, with the exception of the, the power bar there. That goes out in the photo op. That's my, my pumps and all that sort of stuff. It's plugged into, and we end up running it up here to the blow circuit. Don't have that installed. I probably won't get to it today. I also have the black lights for the water room. They're still up in the attic. That will be the last thing I install. I'll have to put them up and wire them in. But for right now, all the other displays have their cameras, their miscellaneous lights. what have you. I've been into the garage and I pulled out all my extension cords. And no, I don't use that many extension cords. It's just ones I've gathered over the year. There's what, 6 different sizes, 6 different lengths. Everything from a 4-foot up to 25-foot in there. And I always pull them all out. That way I can pick and choose what I need for whatever application I'm doing. And go from there. Then the extras get put away. I think last year I showed you a shot like I just did. And then one when I was done, you saw all the extra ones I had left over. But I'm going to go out. We're going to start out at the front end of the haunt where the entrance and exit gates are, and we're going to start getting things wired and just work our way down the driveway. You're trying to get T1, everything that goes into T1 plugged in, and if we have time, we'll start on once we get to this point in here, I'll just start going through the haunt getting things plugged into whatever system they go to. But for right now, I should be able to get the front end Gypsy, half a clown, spider, witch, and pirate all into T1. I do have one line for the head count camera out at the exit. I need to run over into the photo op. And if I do that, I might as well take that over, at least get it set into place and just drop the cord over the wall, and I'll run the extension cord to the power station at a later date. But tonight, I'll give you a look at what household current stuff that we've got plugged in and on. So that means more cell phone editing. Yay!
Okay, it's going on about 8:30. I'm still working out here, but I figured I'd give you a look at what I've gotten done so far. We've been kind of hopping all over the place. Started out here. We got the exit sign done, the buzzards done, the inner sign done, and then if I'll come on, I got 2 sets of peepers in the bush. Okay, kind of wig people out. Now hold on a sec. All right, sorry about that. Had to get the gates closed. The other thing I do have working too is the witch. I have her set up to run off a Scooby Boo board, which means she's in the off mode at the moment. But if I touch the wires together that go to the Scooby Boo board, she triggers. So she is working. I did check her out. Camera has its power cord ran over to the blow circuit, which is not plugged in yet. We got this lamp on. This is on. And let's see up there. That tray should be moving and it's not. I may have to maintenance it. And we've got the scrying bowl, Mr. working. I'm gonna go over here and look at this tray first. It was acting a little weird when I plugged it in. Okay. It should be working and it's not. Oh, there it goes. Now the cups over there on the other side are supposed to be bouncing up and down. They aren't because I don't have the air or low voltage hooked up yet. So those are going to have to wait. But we got that working. In the spider room, I got the spiders going and I got a ladder in the way. And we got the camera up there in the corner working. Then over here on this side, I haven't made it to the pirate yet. And I have not gotten to the witch yet. Those are my next 2 scenes to light up. Oh, and I've got one light here. It's up there on the pole. We'll do bats down in here. I haven't gotten hooked up. But the outlet I was working on also powers this half of the clown. So we've got that going. I do have one problem. There's a light up there on the wall. It's the same thing as a fire and ice. And there's an electronic motor in there that spins, that creates all the different shadows. That motor is working in that. The lights are burned out. So I'm going to have to take that down and play around with the lighting in here. But that's what we've gotten done so far.
Pie of the day. Peach pie with whipped cream. Okay, end of the day wrap up. I ended up not going any further after I shot the last segment. I forgot to show you George over in the exit hall. He's working as well. I always forget something out from him in this stage. I do have a repair to do. And it was a mistake on my end. The tray on the table is supposed to slide back and forth. I had trouble during the video not wanting to run. I think I know what the problem was with it. I think I had the tray tightened down too tight on the mechanism, and I was forcing the mechanism to, you know, force the tray back and forth instead of letting it glide back and forth. So I was thinking, well, I was going to loosen that, and I'll do that. I'd do it later. I got done filming the night look at what I got done for you guys. Had Sue come out to have her take a look at it. Kaylee and I parked the truck. And the three of us are coming back in, Kaylee, Sue, and I. And we're about halfway through the gypsy, and all of a sudden I hear the sound of, it sounded like a bunch of quarters or 50 cent pieces hitting the ground. I knew exactly what it was. The motor has a stack of washers on it for that tray, you know, to act as a spacer. The bolt had broken. On it, which caused all the washers to fall off. So I'm going to have to get underneath that table and see if I can fix it and see if there's any damage to the motor. I'm hoping not. But we'll have to kind of go from there. If not, that's going to be a static prop because I'm not taking that table apart all the way and to fix it. But so I've got that to do tomorrow. Other than that, we got the front end done. Enter, exit, arches, the peepers in the bush, and George. We got the witch working, which I did not show you because I didn't feel like triggering it by the trigger wires. Plus the camera out there is wired and ran over to where it's got to be, and it won't be working until I run the power cord for the blow-up circuit, which I won't do for another week or two. I'll worry about that when I'm ready to do the ponds, because the pumps for the ponds plug into that circuit. Gypsy, we got the camera in there working, the scrying bowl, the lamp, and the tray working. And I had no lights on at all, other than that skull light and the cast iron stove, the teapot, it's working. There was a little bit of light with that, and the scrying bowl, and that skull lamp. It was the only light I had on in there while I was trying to show you the tray and the cups. And according to the screen on the cell phone, they were showing up with no problem whatsoever. So I think the nighttime videos are going to be really, really good if it's acting like that with that much low light. We also got the camera in the spider and the spider light in the spider working. So that display's done. And we got the jack-in-the-box portion of the clown working. I do have a light in there I need to replace. So there's one on the other side of the wall in with the hammering clown. The fire and ice light. And those things have usually two to three different colored LED lights, plus a lens that rotates that helps create the fire and ice look. I plugged it in, lights aren't coming on, but you put your hand on the fixture and you can feel the motor working on the inside turning the disc. They have a little bit of a vibration to them. when they're plugged in and working because of that disc on the lens on the inside rotating. Well, it's vibrating. The lens is rotating. It's just that the lights are burned out. So it doesn't mean no good there. So I'm going to have to unplug it, remove it, and see what I can do about switching it out. I got a possible replacement for it, but I don't know if I want to go that route. It's a fire and ice light, but it's like 6 inches long and screws into like a regular outlet. And I got plenty of clamp lights, so I could put a clamp light up there with one of those in there. But I don't know if I want that up there or not, especially right by where the hammer and clown is and that barrel that shoots water up in the air. I don't know how far it's going to splash. So, I'm not sure. Oh, I'll have to think about that one overnight. But anyway, I got those two repairs. Now, I still have the courtyard to do. I've got one camera and a light that does bats on the ground that I need to put in here or plug in yet. I've got the witch to do. And I've got the pirate to do. And then trunk line one will be totally done. Then we can just start working our, I'll turn on trunk line 2, trunk line 3, and we'll just start working our way through the haunt, getting things plugged in and working. I feel like we made it quite a ways today. We got all the trunk lines in yesterday. I got all the household current items out here, hung up into place, except for the black lights. I explained about that earlier. I'm thinking the way this is going and with debugging, I won't have it done tomorrow, which is Tuesday. I should be done Wednesday, sometime on Wednesday, I'm thinking, unless something really unforeseen happens. And we should be into stage 4 by Thursday, which is all the low voltage, and that's what takes forever. And Sue Ann's waiting for me to get into that one. Then she can come out and start doing her finishing touches on things and stuff as I get done in areas and get the hay and stuff in. So, got our work cut out for us. Got our marching orders for tomorrow. Stay spooky. Stay toxic.